On the Lower East Side, where I was brought up, it was kind of cool to be a drug dealer. It was even cooler to do drugs. It was bad. It was every corner. It was someone selling drugs or trying to get you to sell drugs, and it was just a way of living in the Lower East Side. It's a way to make money. And I come from a family where, like, my mother sold drugs, and she's from the Lower East Side. You know, my father sold drugs, and he was from the Lower East Side, and they both got addicted to drugs as well. Didn't take long to be, like, just sucked into that trap. I'd say about 16 years old, I started, like, holding drugs for drug dealers, and then at some point, wanted to make some extra money. Might as well just sell the drugs.
While he was in the street, he was also supporting his family. By selling drugs, you could make a lot of money, and Edgar was basically taking care of his two younger siblings, and also he has an older brother as well.
528 East 11th Street is a building that I used to sell drugs out of. Not only did I sell drugs out of it, the first time I ever experienced heroin was there. The last time I was arrested was there. And the first time I ever met Mr. Nelson was there.
The first time I actually met him was when I was going into my building, and he was in front of the building actually throwing up. And he asked me if I could help him. So he said, look, I'm using 10 bags of heroin. I want to get out of this. I want to change. I don't want to sell drugs no more. So when he told me this, I said, I'm willing to help you.
They cracked down hard at one point on the Lower East Side, tried to clean it up. And that's when the police department was really in the neighborhood. And, you know, like anyone else, at some point, you're going to get caught. You know, I got caught a couple times. The last time I was arrested, it was for, I had about 15 bags of heroin in my pocket or something like that.
Edgar Muniz got arrested for sale of controlled substance, of selling heroin. And by selling heroin, it's a felony charge. With this charge, he could have gone upstate 3.5 as a minimum, but the maximum could have been more jail time. That's when Andrew Glover started getting involved with him.
When that point came when I was gonna go to jail, they called him up, and Nelson spoke to my probation officer.
I basically told him, give me the opportunity of working with him, and the probation said yes. We asked the judge and told the judge that we want him to go to a drug treatment program.
Yeah, I must have cried to him as well. You know, he told me, I'm gonna give you one more shot. You know, I spoke to her already, and she's gonna allow you to get treatment, you know, to go into a program. You know, I must have cried like a baby. I must have cried like a baby that day. Nelson was always in touch with me. You know, even when I graduated high school up there, he was up there for that. He was always around. You know, really appreciate that. He'd be willing to help anyone in my family, which was great, which was really great. I'm crazy how I met him. I think about it, but only God knows what would have happened to me.
Today, Edgar is a professional. He's a family man, a married man, a person that people could actually respect. And at the Andrew Glover Youth Program, we're all very proud of his success.
I have a successful career. I'm on a radio show Monday through Friday for the last 4 years in Long Island, Spanish radio. I also manage three real estate offices here in New York City. So, you know, I'm doing that, and that's phenomenal. Life is good right now. I just got married, you know, and life is good. I'm working on a baby right now. Life is really good. Life is good.
I'm very happy with Edgar. I'm, like, so overwhelmed with everything that he's accomplished, from a young person that was using drugs to recovering, going to a program for 3.5 years, graduating from high school, going to Drake Business School, going to college. And for him today being involved in real estate and being in charge and managing like 15 people is amazing to me. It's like he brightens up my day and gives me the strength of moving forward and helping other kids.
I feel like I'm giving back to the Andrew Glover program, and I feel like I owe them a lot more. So this is a way for me to just say, hey, give someone a second chance and keep a program like this, like the Andrew Glover program, around so they can help, you know, kids who unfortunately get caught up in the situation that I was in.
And he's a proven fact that with the help of Andrew Glover Youth Program and Andrew Glover's resource, that young people could change just like Edgar Muniz.